Dímelo, Corillo, que es la que hay.
Bienvenido
a un nuevo video de la Bombina de Michi. Y Nancy, welcome my peeps, what's going on? Welcome to one of the Bombina's videos, Nancy.
Y Michi.
Yes. House tent in Puerto Rico in the street with his kids and his wife. And not only him, a lot of people in Puerto Rico are doing that. Okay? Because you can trust the house inside. If y'all seen the news, y'all saw how it fell apart. Sorry, my people, we got a little bit dramatic.
Okay, pasó eso. Mi tía se salió de allá de donde vivía. Mi hermana estaba en pánico con los tres nenes. Se le rajó el balcón de mi prima. De mi hermana, disculpen. De mi hermana se le rajó el balcón porque ya vive en un tercer piso. Mi primo vive en Yauco. Y su casa completamente se craqueó. Ellos están afuera en la calle durmiendo en casas de campaña con sus tres nenas y su esposa. Es fuerte saber que un familiar tuyo está pasando por eso y que no simplemente tu familia, todo el mundo está pasando eso en Puerto Rico. Estamos hablando de toda el área del sur de Ponce, Guánica, Peñuela, Yauco, Guayanilla, Guánica, Lajas, toda esa área del sur está pasando por estos temblores. Todavía los temblores siguen, no han parado los temblores.
Yeah, they haven't stopped. They still continue going. A lot of people have I seen that wrote in Facebook that we were dramatic, that it wasn't all that.
Mm-hmm.
In order for you to say that we were dramatic and that it wasn't all that, you have to be there. You have to be there because I never been so scared in my life, for my life and for everybody else's mm-hmm. life. This is the first time in my life that I felt like this is it.
Sí, mucha gente dijo en Facebook, estaban diciendo que el área azul era bien dramática. Mucha gente, muchos de los que vivían en el área norte y mucha gente que estaban en los Estados Unidos acá estaba diciendo que esa gente era bien dramática, que ahí no hay nada, que no está pasando nada, pero sí.
Ay, ya. Yeah.
Se siente a diario, todavía se siente a diario. Se rompieron muchas casas y mucha gente sin hogar. No había agua, no había comida, muchas cosas.
No water, a lot
el
of
gobierno terrible.
No water, the government, you already know
that.
I'm not even going to get into that subject. No water, no light. How we took a shower. Michi's mother had two big tanks.
Thank you.
And with that, we had her take a bucket. Half for Michi, half for me. That's how we all took a shower there. Michi, her mom, her dad, her sister, her two kids, and her husband. Because we were all there, Michi's mom's mm-hmm. house. That's after that happened, the big one, that's when her sister came over.
Después de ese día del 7 de enero, ya la vida de, te puedo decir, la vida de las personas del sur en Puerto Rico y todas las que pasaron, que no eran del sur, que simplemente estaban de vacaciones y qué sé yo qué, las vidas de ellos no volvieron a ser las mismas. Créeme que esto no.
Our life wasn't the same. I say ours because for us too, because we were there, we experienced the big one. For us, it was a humongous one. You know, your life is not the same. I mean, like I told you, Michi's mom turned to zombie. Michi panicked all the time that it would happen. I turned to Rambo mode.
Mm-hmm.
Like, anything that I would see on my way, I get it out. I gotta get the doors open. I gotta get everybody out. And then I would think survival. Let's do this.
So, brincamos de una historia para otra, pero es
yeah,
lo mismo.
From one
bubble, cuando pasó el temblor del día 7, que eso fue en la madrugada, ya por la mañana, llegó toda mi familia a casa de mi mamá, ¿te acuerdas?
Mm-hmm.
Gracias a Dios, que mi mamá y mi papá, ellos diariamente viven en un modo de sobrevivencia, porque en Puerto Rico cada rato se va la luz y cada rato se va el agua. Eso ya mi mamá está preparada. Mi mamá siempre tiene agua embotellada. Mi mamá tiene unos tanques de agua que mi mamá siempre llena los tanques de agua. Siempre mi mamá está preparada y ella tiene una estufa de gas y tiene su estufa eléctrica y tiene su estufa de gas. So, gracias a Dios que mi mamá estaba en ese modo de survivor, que ella guardó el agua, tenía comida, tenía la estufa de gas, todo el mundo ese día subió, ¿verdad? ¿Te acuerdas? Estaba todo oscuro y todo el mundo subió para en casa de mi mamá. Y ahí mi mamá preparó café y teníamos pan que habíamos comprado, pan del día anterior. So, en esa parte estábamos preparados.
Yeah.
Pero no estábamos preparados para el temblor. Eso no, no pues, claro.
Que after that, the day 7th of the big one, the 6.6 earthquake. After that, all Mitch's, we didn't go to sleep at all. We stayed all the way up, all the way to the morning. Well, we didn't go back to sleep at all.
No,
so all Mitch's family came over Mitch's mom's house, because Mitch's mom, they're already, like, Mitch's mom and dad, they're already prepared, like, for survival. Like, they got a gas stove separate from the regular stove, the electric stove. They got a tank full of, you know, gas for the gas stove. And she has the tanks full of
the water.
Waters. Mm-hmm. And because all the time in Puerto Rico this happens, like I told you, they haven't fixed nothing. In Puerto Rico, it's not
se
updated.
Va el agua, se va el luz.
The light goes away quick,
just
for a little wind, and the water goes quick. For any little thing, the water goes and the light goes. So you gotta get prepared when you live in Puerto Rico for this kind of survival. Puerto Rico is a beautiful island, my people, but you gotta be prepared for stuff like this. Michi and I wasn't, and neither was my sister, my niece, and my other niece. We wasn't prepared for this, because this is the first time that this happened to us.
¿Qué pasó a nosotros? Desde ese día, por la noche, ya tuvo todo ese día sin luz, no tuvimos luz. Todo ese día decidimos dormir afuera. Teníamos que voy a poner un cantito del video para que vean dónde estábamos durmiendo, que tengo video. Eso sí tengo video.
Yeah, Mitch is going to put a little clip of the...
Estábamos en el patio.
Where we were, because we went outside. Mitch said, let's take the sofas outside. Because Mitch's mom said, I don't want to sleep no more inside the house.
Como no podemos dormir adentro, mira lo que hicimos. Sacamos los muebles de mamá y para afuera. En el patio. Con las estrellas del cielo oscuro. Estamos aquí. Nos tocó sacar los muebles de la casa. Al patio y acostarnos en ellos para así todos están juntos y esperando en Dios que no pase nada. Aquí tengo a mi mami durmiendo.
My people, we just finished taking out the sofa from inside the house. We took it out in the backyard. We're about to sleep outside. Yes. So God bless and keep praying for us, my people. So we took the sofas outside and we were sleeping outside. That's where all the mosquitoes kicked my butt.
Your butt?
Yeah. They ate my legs, all of them. Yeah, fresh meat. So we took the sofas outside. We were sleeping outside with the pillows, covers, everything outside. We didn't have no light.
No, they don't light.
So you already know that I couldn't sleep with the machine. So I was worried because Michi's sister and her husband, they got racing cars. Racing cars. Really, really nice cars. So you already know the thieves come out at night. The thieves come out at
night.
Eso
es lo malo.
That's the bad thing about that.
Lo malo es que a pesar... ¿Cómo te explico? Esto pasa en todos lugares. No te estoy diciendo que nada más pasa en Puerto Rico. Esto pasa en todo el país del mundo. Donde hay gente buena, hay gente mala.
Yeah, all over the world. There's good people and bad people. But when things like that happen, that's when all the bad people comes out.
Sí, cuando pasan cosas así, en vez de la gente unirse y hacer cosas, y sale la gente mala. A hacer escante, a asaltar, a robar, a cogerlo de la otra gente, a matar gente y hacer cosas. So,
instead of people getting united, they come out to do bad things, to steal, to go into people's houses. You know, you're supposed to get united and help each other.
¿Tú te imaginas tú pasando por ese proceso de que tú estás pasando por un mal momento y que venga otra persona a hacerte pasar otro mal momento? Porque es así.
I know. You could imagine we were already going to everything. Look at everything that me and Michi be carrying and the whatever we were carrying. You understand our stuff. And we said, well, we don't care to lose. If it was meant, okay, take it all. I don't care. But you understand, you passing through all these bad moments, and then we have to worry about that somebody might come in through the backyard and hold us up. Because we had to open the gates.
Mm-hmm. Había que dejar las puertas abiertas.
You know, and we had to open the doors, all the doors. So we were sleeping, and then I didn't have the machine, so I was worried about that, because I didn't have the machine on. So I said, okay, I could go to sleep, and that wake up, or somebody could come over here and rob us, or kill us, or whatever, for the change we have, or whatever, change we have in our pocket, whatever. I said, so you had a lot of worries, so we slept a little bit. We slept 5-10 minutes, we woke up. 5-10 minutes, we woke up. And then it was always earthquakes.
Temblaba,
not
temblaba.
Strong, but always earthquakes. And then you heard the noise. Mm-hmm. Ooh. In one of those times that we were outside, my people, that we were in the sofa like that, looking up, this thing in the sky called a train that come out. Came out.
Okay.
They call it a train.
60 son?
61. The 60 trains?
Something like that.
They call the 60 train something
los
like
la 60 luz, you, 60 train,
it see? Was like something like a, you know, like a snake going like that. Lights, like that.
Sí, una... Estaba pasando, cuando estábamos ahí en el cielo, estaban pasando un montón de luces, derechito, una línea.
They were all in line.
Le llaman los 60 satélites, ahora
oh,
sí.
Oh, the 60 satellites, that's
creo
what they call.
Algo así. 60, 70 satélites.
60 satellites, but it looked like a train, like running.
De
like
luces.
Like that. Of lights.
Nosotros nos paniqueamos.
We panic.
¿Por qué?
Aquí se acabó el mundo.
Yo dije, aquí se acabó el mundo. Se acabó el mundo.
I said, that's it. That's the end of the world. Omnis. They're gonna take me. Yeah.
Nosotros parecían como si estuvieran de camping. Lo único que nos alumbraba a nosotros era la luna.
Yeah. We felt like we were out camping. The only light we had is the moon. The moon and the stars. Mm-hmm. That's the only light. Because it gets pitch black. There's no light nowhere. Nowhere in Puerto Rico, so you know it's pitch black.
Llegaba la noche, mi gente, y nosotros nos paniqueamos. Yo me paniqueaba, mi corazón a millón. Yo no podía dormir, estábamos amanecidas, horrible.
When it was already beginning to get dark, we already was panicking.
Porque no había
luz. We already knew, oh my God.
Nos turneaban.
That's when it most came. The earthquake, that's when it murphed, and then you're scared because there's no light. So if you have to run, where the hell are you going to run?
Mm-hmm.
Mitch's dad, that's the first time I see him worry. You know, I said, he said, in he sat like that in the balcony, he said, oh my God, what am I going to do? I said, you can't do anything.
Mi papá estaba bien preocupado.
He was real worried. He said, what am I going to do? I said, you can't do anything. All we got to do is survive. Try to survive. So he said, look, there's a spot back there in the backyard. If anything happens, let's just all stand there because there's nothing that could fall. Like the house, if it falls, it could fall. Because Mitch's mom's house is in a, up a hill like that, so if it fall, it was gonna fall that way, or it was gonna go down. So we all decided we were gonna just stand there, you know, if something like that big would also happen. It was horrible. Mm-hmm. I remember one time at 8:55 in the morning. It was 8:55. I just finished coming out of the bathroom.
Ese día estábamos haciendo turno.
We were taking turns of
sleeping. Porque estábamos viendo gente pasando por ahí, mirando los carros y mirando para la casa.
A lot of people going around. Because like I said, her sister and her husband got racing cars. They got really got nice cars. So all the people kept coming around looking.
Ese día estábamos de turno.
So we were like taking turns.
Nos parábamos en el balcón tal 3-4 horas, te acostabas a dormir un ratito, venía mi hermana y se quedaba ahí, o venía Nancy y se quedaba ahí,
esposo,
así.
We were like taking turns. We didn't mean to take turns. We didn't say, okay, you're going to stay up like that. It just happened like that.
Mm-hmm.
No fue que quisimos. No nos dijimos, okay, tú vas a hacer. Es que pasó así.
Pasó así.
La hermana de Michi estaba en el balcón, se acostaba a dormir. Yo estaba durmiendo. De momento me despertaba, me iba yo al balcón. It was like that. Like, her sister went to sleep. And I will wake up, go to the balcony, or I will go to sleep, and she will go up, go to the balcony. It's crazy the way it happened, and we didn't even talk about this. I think it happened automatically like that. It was crazy. And then, at that day, at 8:55 in the morning, that one was a pretty strong one, too. It was 5 point something. Mm-hmm. It was pretty strong, that one. Okay? But it was daytime. It was 9:55 a.m.
And
I remember Michi just finished sitting like that in the bed because then right there we took the beds out of the room and we put it right there because we couldn't sleep no more outside.
Porque así la picaron los mosquitos,
because
la
the
muraron,
mosquitoes tore me up.
Cante.
They really tore me up. Let me see if Michi got, I really don't know. So I said, okay, if we go over there, if we go over here, still the same thing. Earthquake over here, maybe over there, the bomb. Yeah. You know what? Let's just ride this. But yeah, it was scary, my people.
So true. Why did you take a photo there?
But if she got a picture on there, she could put a picture right around here. Don't put too much, my miamon. Show one of those mosquito bites. It looked terrible.
Abusaron de los mosquitos.
They really tore me
up. So no podíamos dormir ya fuera por los mosquitos.
So we couldn't sleep outside. So we said, okay, let's take a chance right here in the living room. So we took the mattresses out of the room.
La madre en el piso.
The box and everything. We just put it right
there.
Michi's mom in the sofa. The other kids one in the sofa. The other one over there. The only one that went to the room was Michi's dad.
Papi era el único.
Because he said, well, at least I could go to the room. I could run, you know. I could run faster if I'm alone there. I don't have to worry about getting somebody and trying to get him out. I could run. And he slept with the door open. So we didn't really sleep, my people. So that's why everybody said, my God, Nancy, you.
Y la cosa era que mi papá estaba trabajando, sí. Lo llamaron para trabajar. So, había temblor o no hubiera temblor, mi papá tenía que ir a trabajar.
Bitch's dad had her go to work, but he stood in the house for a couple of days.
Yeah,
he said,
quedó en la casa.
I'm not going to leave my family. I'm going to stay here. When he comes down, then. Okay. And then your body, mentally and physically, you're drained.
Ni hambre te daba.
You don't even get hungry.
Mm-mm.
Michi's mom lost 18 pounds. 18 pounds like this.
And nada.
Okay. I don't know if I lost any pounds. Because I eat bread like crazy.
De hecho, comía unos pan.
We used to eat bread every day because that's all we got. Bread and eggs from Michi's mother's chickens back there. And the stove, of
mi
course, we already got the gas.
Yes,
that was the good thing.
Mi mamá bajó 18 libras por como estaba, ya parecía un zombie. Ella
she looked like a zombie. She didn't even feel like eating.
Nada,
and Michi's
no
mom,
quería comer ni nada.
She could eat, yo.
Mi mamá
she could eat what me and Michi could eat together, maybe another person too. She could eat that.
Mami come bien.
And you better run if she could try to eat you too. Ah! I'm just kidding. So anyway, now. So like I was saying, 8:55 in the morning, and I just finished coming out of the bathroom. Michi was right there sitting on the mattress, half asleep. Yo. Mitch's mom was taking out the Christmas tree, and the kids were helping her put it into boxes and everything like that. So there was a whole bunch of boxes and everything like that. The back door was closed. Mitch's dad was back there feeding the chickens and the roosters, whatever he was doing. When that house started shaking, right there I seen, because I was awake. I was awake, and not only that, it was light. So I got to see everything. Yo, everything was like in slow motion. I went like this. I looked all around. And that was like, whoa, whoa. Survival mode came into my mind. I started kicking those boxes out of the way. I grabbed those kids. I opened the back door. I threw them out. I said, run, everybody. I tried to get Michi out of the bed. I fell on top of Michi. And Michi's mom.
Yo no podía levantar de la cama porque se estaba meneando la casa.
And I could hear Michi's dad from back there, get out, get out. But we're four.
So ese día. Como estaba diciendo, ese día nos estábamos turneando porque estábamos pendientes a los carros y que nadie se fuera a meter dentro de la casa a hacernos nada. So, nos estábamos turneando automáticamente, no fue ni que lo hablamos, ni lo planeamos, ni nada. Simplemente me paraba yo en el balcón, estaba 1 o 2 horas y me daba como sueño, volvía otra vez para la cama y ahí se paraba mi hermana, no veía a nadie, volvía, ella se levantaba o me acostaba yo y se acostaba a mi hermana y después Nancy se iba a velar, así estábamos. No era como que Nancy, no, vete, te toca a ti, es tu turno. No estábamos en esa. Era ya como estábamos
automáticamente
estábamos haciendo eso. So, ya estábamos durmiendo dentro de la casa porque ya Nancy le picaron los mosquitos. Ya Nancy, los mosquitos hicieron escante con ella, abusaron de ella los mosquitos. So, no pudimos dormir más nada afuera. So, estábamos durmiendo en la sala. En la sala de en casa de mi mamá pusimos matres, los muebles, los nenes aquí, los nenes allá. El único que estaba durmiendo en el cuarto era mi papá. Porque él decía, no, duerman ustedes allá porque yo puedo correr y no estoy pendiente a que, mira, levántate tú.
Mitch is saying everything that I said in English about her dad sleeping in the room, about that we took turns and everything like that automatically without even noticing that we were taking turns, that she's saying that in English.
Eso estoy diciendo yo en español, no en inglés.
I mean in Spanish.
So,
my brain's still not working, my people.
So pasó eso, nada, okay. Ese día a las 8 de la mañana.
A las 8:55.
A las 8:55.
So
yo estaba tratando de levantarme del piso porque yo estaba cansadísima. So Nancy estaba en el baño, estaban los nenes, mi mamá estaba sacando el árbol de Navidad, poniéndolo en caja y qué sé yo qué. So Nancy empezó a temblar. So Nancy empezó a correr, rompió a meter patas a todas las cajas que habían, a sacar a mis sobrinos para afuera. Mi mamá salió corriendo, mi papá gritando desde el patio allá, corran, salgan, un revolú. Y yo en el en la cama todavía. No en la cama, en el matre tirado en el piso. Porque traté de levantarme y como se estaba meneando, no me pude levantar. So, como estaba en el piso, pues no pude levantarme. Solo así me cayó encima.
I know, I tried to pull it out of that bed in the floor. I went right along with her. I fell right on top of her. I said, oh, God.
No.
That was we didn't have no vacation.
So, decidimos traernos a mi mamá. Mi mamá se quiso venir con nosotros.
So, we decided we're going to bring Mitch's mom with us.
Duró con nosotros como 3 semanas, ¿verdad?
She lasted here for three weeks.
Mi papá se quedó solo.
Her dad stayed. Her sister moved to Maryland with her kids and her husband.
Sí.
And she said she don't want to go back. I don't know. I hope she don't go back. And her mom went back.
Sí, mami volvió para atrás.
She después, said she no, couldn't, no podía. She couldn't be without her husband. Entonces, and it's understandable.
Ella estaba aquí y decía, yo no puedo dejar a mi esposo solo allá en la casa, que le vaya a pasar algo, que porque había que dejar las puertas abiertas, todavía siguen los temblores, un desastre.
Yeah.
So, ella no pudo más y se regresó otra vez para Puerto Rico. Dice que gracias a Dios ella no ha cogido, no ha pasado nada grande, 1, 2 y 3, Dios mío, Señor, que no pase nada, en verdad, porque horrible, Puerto Rico no está preparado para eso. Es más, nadie está preparado para eso, mm-hmm. Pero Puerto Rico no está preparado. Puerto Rico no se ha puesto bien desde María. So, todavía Puerto Rico tiene las calles destruidas. Se han perdido muchas casas.
Yeah, a lot of houses. We
mucha
lost
gente
a lot of
se
houses.
Suicidó.
A lot of people killed themselves, my people.
Sí, mucha gente murió también,
lost,
que le cayeron
they
encima.
They lost all their belongings. I understand. Over here in the United States, you don't think like that, because I don't think like that. People in Puerto Rico, they hold on, they clinch into their stuff. I don't know if I'm saying that right. If they got a house or a car, they stay with it forever, and they take care of it for nothing to happen. So they clinch, they like, sí. Hugging. I don't know how to tell you this.
Es que en Estados Unidos. La vida en Estados Unidos se trata de trabajar y trabajar, porque eso se sabe. Pero en Estados Unidos conseguir las cosas es un poco más fácil.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Porque tú trabajas y tienes el dinero para comprarlas.
That's what it is, because out here in the United States, it's more easier for us to get. If we lose everything, well, we know we're going to have a little hard time, but we're going to get it. Over there in Puerto Rico, if you lose it.
You lose it.
Because people that have lost their house in Maria. In the Hurricane Maria, still haven't got their house. A lot of people. And there's still a lot of people that's not going to get their house.
Todavía hay gente que no tiene las casas.
Okay. So, people tend to clench into their stuff. They tend to hug. You know, they cherish. And I don't understand it. And maybe a lot of you is not going to understand it. Because over here in the United States, we think different. If I lose that, hey, then my life is better. My life is more important to me. But they don't think like that. So a lot of people, when they lost all their belongings, that's it.
Se quitaron la vida.
They took their life away.
Y mama,
a lot
mama,
of people took their life
pero
away.
Pero más las personas mayores.
More the elderly.
Como que no podían aguantar.
They couldn't handle. And then the young people, what they did from the south of Puerto Rico, they packed their stuff and they left.
Mm-hmm.
Even a plane fell because of so much going back and forward to Miami, to Florida.
Sí,
so much going, so it burned it out.
El área sur está completamente vacía, pero mucha gente se ha ido. Mucha gente no le ha importado la casa, mucha gente sí, mucha gente se ha quitado la vida porque no es tanta la desesperación que no aguantan la presión de que, y no tanto de que pierda las cosas, sino como que, yo no quiero estar, si fue este fuerte, yo no quiero esperar que pase otro, so déjame quitarme la vida.
Yeah, a lot of people, like a lady, she said I won't be able to take another second one, and she just threw herself out of the balcony.
Se tiró del balcón para abajo.
You understand? A lot of people can't handle it. You know, a lot of people say, you know, this is it. What for? What I got to live for?
Mm-hmm.
And they can't handle the pressure.
Y ya mucha gente se pone como que, okay, si pasa pues, me morí aquí ya.
And a lot of people say, okay, if it happens, well,
I got here.
A lot of Mitch's family, they all say it.
Lo mismo.
They stay in Puerto Rico and they say, this is my island. I'm going to stay with my island, whatever happens. You understand? I wasn't raised in Puerto Rico. I love my island. I'm not saying that I don't. But if I could think that I could live in the United States and try to make it, I'm you know, that's the way I think. I think different. But maybe because I was raised out here in the United States. Maybe that's why. But maybe not, because Michi doesn't think like that either.
¿De qué?
Right? You don't think like you have to go and live in Puerto Rico because that's your island.
Es mi isla, pero I don't know, en este momento yo no me veo viviendo en Puerto Rico.
Yeah, Michi says you don't find herself living in Puerto Rico.
No.
And I understand a lot of people that do. I understand
y
that.
Y es mi isla y todo, pero...
And I love my island, but...
No me
yeah,
veo.
That's a big but.
Yeah.
But I don't see myself living in Puerto Rico. That's a big decision. Mm-hmm. A big decision, especially with other earthquakes. I mean, it could happen here too, I'm not saying. Puede pasar aquí también.
Entonces nosotros estábamos como que, ok, estamos en Puerto Rico cogiendo los temblores. Ok, me voy para Estados Unidos porque queremos huir. Bueno, yo pensaba eso. Porque quiero pagar los 2,000 pesos y me quiero ir para mi casa. Para evitar todo esto, pero acá estamos pensando, okay, ¿y si pasa la bomba de la guerra?
I know, because when that was happening, that's when they were saying that the bomb was going to come over here to the United States because of what was going on, you already know.
Explicarle y queríamos que supieran lo que nosotros pasamos en Puerto Rico y que todavía sigue la gente pasando en Puerto Rico.
Well, we wanted to make this video. I don't know if it's going to be one or two or three parts. I don't know how long this video is going to be. But we wanted to make this video so y'all know what we went through in Puerto Rico. A lot of people told us, why didn't we video anything, any of the earthquake? You don't think about cameras and stuff. Like, I didn't think about no cameras.
No.
I know there's a lot of people that did, but I didn't.
No.
I didn't, and Missy didn't either.
Mm-mm.
I didn't think out my mind.
Porque tuve.
We could have.
Pero no.
But, you know, no. We turned into survival mode right there. I said
yo
no.
Lo que quería era sobrevivir, que mi familia estuviera bien.
That's it. Then,
y que todas las personas en Puerto Rico estuvieran bien, no que la gente viera cómo estaba pasando.
No, yeah, we're not, like, we don't think, like, if there's a fight right there or somebody's killing somebody, okay, let me record this. That's not my way of thinking. And I see a lot of people that does that, you know, and, you know, to each his own, but I won't. I can't, because my mind, it turned to survival mode mentally and everything, physically, everything turned into survival mode. That's all I had in my mind. And my family that was out
gente,
here.
So, mi gente, por favor, les pido
oh, yeah,
de corazón,
ask,
de parte de las bombinas
please,
y de todo Puerto Rico,
behalf,
sigan orando por la gente de Puerto Rico.
Keep praying for people in Puerto Rico.
Que nada pase.
That nothing will happen because I know that if some big one, other than 7... point whatever, Puerto Rico's not gonna be able to hold it. This Puerto Rico's real weak right now, real weak. You put something on the floor and the floor just shakes without no stopping. Okay, you put something on the floor and you can feel it. It's shaking. The floor is
completamente
constantly.
Hasta
right
tú
there.
Te sientas en el mueble y tú sientes que se tiembla todo.
When we were in Mitch's mom's house, cars were passing in front of Mitch's mom's house and you could feel it inside the living room.
Mm-hmm.
Under the ground, it shakes even more. So the ground is still shaking a lot. And every once in a while, it shakes. It shakes, but it's constantly shaking. So we ask prayers from all of y'all, all over the world, please, whoever's watching us. Oraciones para nuestros familiares en la gente de Puerto Rico. Para todo el mundo. Para todo
y no,
el mundo
y no
Puerto
para Puerto Rico. Para el mundo
oh,
completo,
para el mundo entero.
Completo.
Not only for Puerto Rico, for the whole world. Because I know a lot of stuff is happening.
Well,
we were having earthquakes over there, here, over there. And Canada was having an earthquake too. Over there in Jamaica.
Y lo que está pasando con el virus ese del coronavirus.
And now everything that's happening
China,
with this virus in China. And in...
Half
Korea and everything. Just prayers for everything
for
that's happening
everything.
On the around the world. And
nosotros creemos mucho en Dios.
We do believe strongly in God, and we do believe. We hold on to God, and He's the only one that could have put this on control.
Yeah.
Everything is under His hands. I would say that. But anyway, prayers for everybody around the world.
So, mi gente. Hasta aquí el videito de hoy, espero que haya gustado. Si es así, no olvides suscribirse, darle like, compartir. Gracias por ser parte de la bambina. Suscribirse es de gratis, te puedes suscribir y nos puedes dejar algún comentario. Gracias por escuchar nuestra historia. Sé que el video fue un poco largo y maybe lo partimos en dos partes, pero queríamos que supieran lo que nosotros pasamos en Puerto Rico y no fue fácil. No fue fácil, pero gracias a Dios sobrevivimos y aquí estamos de nuevo.
Okay, my peeps, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you already done so. Welcome to the family. And we did this video like this so you could know everything that we went on in Puerto Rico and everything that happened to us. And then we're going to continue doing videos. And We need your support, your help. So please leave a comment below and please leave a like. That's real important. That you leave a comment and a like, please, my people. And
don't forget
that the papinas,
we love you, my gente. Peace and love. Gracias.
Love you. Thank you for listening to us. Love you.